Hello, friends, and welcome. Today, I want to talk with you about what on earth do we do when it comes to sizing a tank? How does that happen? It's so mystical. Nobody ever seems to ever talk about why tanks are sized the way that they're tanked, how that process works, and why does it matter, right? Well, let's get into it. So, septic systems, right? The big thing you have to know about them is that they're going to be basically what's dealing with all of your wastewater from your home, right? They're just a big concrete box. Sometimes they're plastic, sometimes they're other materials, but most of the time they're concrete, right? Just a big rectangle in the yard where all the stuff that you flush goes into, solids will separate out, and then the liquids will work its way into the drain fields or the absorption system, whatever variety you potentially have, right? But there's actually math and science to the sizing of it. Now, depending on your area, I'm not 100% sure on every state's or county's code, but in Maryland, there are a few methods to determine how big of a tank you need, right? So let's get into exactly what is going on. On a modern septic system, modern installed meaning like now, today, you're getting a 1,500 gallon tank that's two chambers with manhole risers front and back. Now, if you have a larger home than a five-bedroom home, generally you'll start to see a 2,000 gallon tank, or you'll see a 1,500 with another one trailing behind it. And the reason why is it's all about occupancy. Now, you may be asking, well, how is occupancy calculated? It's kind of an odd thing to just decide randomly in sizing the tank. Well, so in our state, now it's going to be bedroom count, right? So what we would look at is we would look at the bedrooms by a multiplier of two. So we would assume two people per bedroom. I get it. It sounds kind of goofy. Like, all right, so I've got a five-bedroom house. That means 10 people are going to live here. No, but that's the way that they size it, right? So you're going to take your bedrooms, multiply by two, and the math for this is going to be about 75 gallons per person of daily use, right? So 150 gallons of water per bedroom. So if you have a two-bedroom house, that's 300 gallons, four-bedroom house, 600 gallons, and so on, right? Now, when it comes to sizing the tank, we need to go with a 2x multiplier again. I know, a lot of doubling, right? Well, so the reason they want to do that is they want to basically verify and confirm that they will get enough retention time of that water to get the solids to fall out of the suspension. And when I use the term water, I mean effluent, like the poo water, right? Nothing special. Now, you want to have enough retention time of that liquid and the solids in the tank so it all falls out of suspension and the scum floats to the top, so we get a clear liquid, as clear as you can get, going out and into the absorption system. The reason that that's important is to make sure that you're not getting any additional biomat into the drain fields, which can cause premature failure. We'll cover biomat in another video, and we'll cover drain fields in another video as well. But the tank, you want to have enough retention time. So if we've got a four-bedroom home that does a peak daily flow of 600 gallons of water, if we have a 2x multiplier, that means the minimum size that that tank needs to be is 1,200 gallons. Now, in our area, we will generally use 750, 1,000, 1,250, 1,500, 2,000. Again, remember, caveat, modern tanks, you're getting a 1,500 gallon regardless. But you go back 20 years, that's the way that it would be. So if we had a four-bedroom home, that means that we're going to want a 1250 tank, right? Because it's bigger than 1200, and 1,000 gallons would be way too small for the 1200 gallons that we know that eight people are going to use. So we have our sizing, we have our retention time, and then they're going to put the tank in, right? Now, generally, the manufacturer is going to dictate like the dimensions of it. So when we're using the term gallons, it could be 8x4, it could be 10x5. It just depends on the height, depends on where the liquid level in that tank's gonna be. That's very manufacturer specific, but generally in our area, they're gonna be roughly about the same. Your area might be different. Our area uses rectangles, but if we go a little bit further north to Pennsylvania, sometimes you'll see circles, right? And every now and again in like the bordering counties and the bordering towns of Maryland to Pennsylvania, you'll find some small installs of circular tanks, right? But when you're sizing this stuff up, it's important to know the math. And the reason it's important is that let's just say you want to build an addition on your home. You might be confused as to why is the county asking me to upgrade my septic. It's because of the retention time, right? And so the other thing you need to consider is the volume of water that you're putting through. So if you're going to put it usually doesn't matter as much for a four bedroom to a five, because again, you're not really going to go from eight people to 10. It's way more important if you go from a two bedroom to a three bedroom or a two bedroom to a four bedroom. And the reason why is it's a higher percentage increase in the daily flow of that water, right? So a two bedroom house, again, we got two people per bedroom. So that puts four people total, 300 gallons. So if you have a 2x multiplier, that's 600 gallons, meaning a two bedroom home would be perfectly fine with a 750 gallon tank. But if we go from a two bed to a three bed, now we're at six people, you're gonna need to get a little bit higher, right? So now we're gonna be looking at darn near close to 1,000 gallons. That's gonna be a significant increase in the total volume of water in that tank. So the county's gonna get a little bit fussy if you don't upgrade the tank. I hope that this was useful. This is a small, short video today just to kind of go through a little bit more about the tank sizing and the way that we do it. Tell me how your county does it or your town does it. I'm very curious to see if everybody does it the same way, where they just do a multiplier factor of bedrooms times occupants times daily flow, and then they just double whatever that number is and then go with the next size up. Tell me below, I'm curious. Have you ever had to deal with the county on tank sizing? Have you ever attempted to pull a permit and have the county say, I don't know, you can't get this approved until you get a tank replacement or a drain field installation? Let me know below. I'm very curious. If you enjoy this, please hit that like button, subscribe, guys. Till next time.